Hi Naptime friends, it's Tish with Naptime Creations. Welcome back to my channel, or welcome to my channel. And if you are new, don't forget to subscribe so you don't miss out on any of my upcoming videos. Today, I'm going to be working on a commission piece, and they wanted a dirty pour, kind of like a flip cup type style. So I have two 12 by 24 canvases here, and these are black canvases. I got those at Michael's, and then I'll show you the colors that I'm going to use. So we have the Artist Loft Flow Acrylic in magenta, Artist Loft Flow Acrylic in white, Artist Loft Copper. This is super, super, super pretty and shimmery. And then Artist Loft Burnt Umber. So what I did is I mixed up one of each color, and then I also have my Apple Barrel White, which is this one. For these two, I don't know if you can see the colors. Yeah, you can. This is half magenta, half white, mixed up to make a lighter pink. And then this is half burnt umber, half white, to make a little bit of a lighter brown. And then I have a little bit of my regular burnt umber. Ew, that looks disgusting. Okay, and then I have a little bit of my magenta. She said to tone down the magenta, but I think if there's just a tiny bit of the hot pink, it'll come out nice. I think we're going for like a pink camo type vibe, because she said she wanted pink, white, and brown. I love that. So I'm gonna mix my paints up, and I'm gonna do two times the amount of floetrol. I always do 1/3 paint, 2/3 floetrol. So I'm just going to mix those up and I will be right back. My plan is to do some tube explosions and then a straight pour like across the middle. So first I'm going to go in with my white. This is for the straight pour cup. Two cups on there, darn it. Look at that, looks pretty. Now I'm going to go in with my white and start layering my paints in my little tubes here. And when I do this, I like to layer my paints from lightest to darkest color. I feel like you get some nice effects that way, and paint density comes into play, so that helps you get different lacing and cells and stuff like that. So now I'm going to go in with the pink color, and I'm just going to speed this up and play some music in the background so you guys don't get bored. It did take me a little bit to kind of work these canvases because they're pretty big.
Thank you.
Now I'm going to go in with my palette knife and smooth out all of this light brown paint. So that was all I tilted on the first canvas. You can see it drying back behind the one that I'm working on right now. This is the second canvas, and I went in with my white again, and then I'm going to go in with my light pink, just like I did on the first one. I didn't film the cup that I poured for the straight pour going across the middle of the canvas. This one had a little bit more white than the other one, because the other one was looking a little bit dark to me, so I added a little bit more white to my straight pour cup for this canvas, but they kind of look like sisters, I think, so they weren't supposed to be identical. I love that copper color from Artist Loft that I'm pouring in right now. If you guys are looking for a copper, this one's really nice, and it wasn't too expensive. It reminds me of a copper penny. You'll see when I show you the dried piece at the end. You can see the paint starting to explode out of the bottom of the tubes, and that's what I was hoping for. When that happens, you get a lot of white on top, and it gives you some really cool lacing. And it didn't happen on the first pour that I tried, but it did on this one, so I'm not sure what I did differently, but when I do the tube pours, I'm aiming for the white to kind of explode out of the bottom like it was doing, just because I like the lacing that you can get from that. Now I'm going in with the straight pour, and you can see at the end, when I get to the end of the bottom of this cup, how much more white I put in there, just because I wanted to lighten it up a little bit. Now, same thing as the other canvas, I'm going in with the light brown, and I'm going to smooth that out with my palette knife. Thank you. just taking my leftover paint and filling in any spots on the sides that might need a little bit of extra paint. Now let's go in for a close-up. I love this little white and pink section right here, how it's kind of faded. I love, love, love that look. I had some interesting cells pop up on this one. I think it was from the apple barrel paint and the artist loft paint mixing together. I've never had cells like this before. And the only difference that I did with this pour is I didn't use any Deco or Americana paint, but because I always use artist loft and apple barrel. And then these cells popped up and I didn't add any silicone or anything like that. So I don't know. I love this middle section right here where I did the straight pour. I love, love, love that. There's lots of those little fun cells on the side there too. What do you guys think? Let me know down in the comments. So this is the second canvas. And you can see how different they are, but I use the same colors and it has more of those little cells that I was talking about. I love the pink and the white ones right there. So cute. And the copper cells got really big. So I'm thinking it was the apple barrel paint and the artist loft paint that made those white cells. I love this dark brown line from the burnt umber that's going through the copper right here. I love that. So pretty. And you can see in the middle how I was talking about how I used a little bit more white because I didn't want, you know, them to be super dark pieces. But yeah, I think these turned out nice. I will show you guys what they look like once they're dry in a couple days. So this is about 5 days later. These ones took a little bit longer to dry, but they didn't have any cracking or crazing or any type of issues with drying. They dried really nice, so I'm gonna get some varnish on top of these once I get some warm sunny weather. But you can see the copper is super shimmery and pretty. It's very, very metallic. I love it. And I love the copper with the burnt umber and then the lighter brown color I made by mixing the white and the burnt umber together. It gave it a nice kind of gradient look. What do you guys think? Let me know down in the comments. I'd love to hear from you. I hope everybody's having a great day, and I will see you on Friday for another video. Thanks for watching. I appreciate you guys, and don't forget to subscribe if you're not already. Bye!